Beijing is speaking out as more countries impose restrictions on travelers from China. Beijing's foreign ministry says such measures should be based on science. China is facing its worst outbreak yet as it moves away from its strict zero COVID policy. This has prompted countries like the U.S., Japan, and Italy to enforce new testing requirements on travelers from China. The steps are in contrast to Beijing's decision to scrap mandatory quarantine for arriving visitors beginning January 8th.
The current COVID situation in the world continues to call for a science-based response approach and joint effort to ensure safe cross-border travel, keep global industry and supply chain stable, and restore world economic growth. We've always believed that for all countries, COVID response measures need to be science-based and proportionate without affecting normal people-to-people exchange.
The World Health Organization calling the restrictions introduced in response to China's COVID-19 surge understandable, given the lack of information from Beijing. WHO Chief Tedros Adhanom Ghebreyesus urges China to be more forthcoming on its pandemic situation so that a comprehensive risk assessment can be made. Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. not ruling out imposing curbs on travelers from China. Marcos agreeing with Beijing that any decision by Manila must be based on science. The health department sees no need for stricter protocols for now, expressing confidence in existing protocols.
As long as it's based on science and we feel that there's a need, we will do it. But again, it depends on what the true risk is to us. When it's something that is manageable, then I'm sure we can find a way to not completely close our borders to China, but to find a way to have a procedure so that those coming from China who may have been exposed or who may have been infected will be tested.
Marcos is pushing through with his three-day state visit to China next week. The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department says arrangements will be made to minimize the health risks to the president and his delegation.
We have received assurances from our Chinese hosts that all arrangements are being made to ensure the safety of the president and his delegation during the visit. And a bubble arrangement has been agreed for the Philippine delegation.
Marcos also not inclined to extend the country's COVID state of calamity. The Philippine government has been gradually easing various health measures against the pandemic.
Still very, very hesitant to continue the state of calamity, to extend it, because again, we are not in a state of calamity anymore, technically speaking. And that is the wrong mindset to be approaching the new year with. So we're still trying to find ways to continue to provide the benefits to our medical health workers, which is the main issue, without the state of calamity.
The health department has asked Marcos to approve a three-month extension of the COVID state of calamity declaration. It warns lifting the status may weaken the country's COVID response strategies, but it adds it is open to alternatives to ensure an undisrupted vaccination program. The West Philippine Sea issue will be high on the agenda during Marcos's state visit to China. The Foreign Affairs Department says the two countries are expected to sign a deal which aims to prevent mishaps in the Philippine territory.
There are other agreements, for example, to avoid miscalculation and miscommunication in the West Philippine Sea. Both sides have agreed to sign an agreement establishing direct communication between the foreign ministries of both countries at various levels, no? And that is expected to be signed by Secretary Manalo and his counterpart, State Councilor and Foreign Minister Wang Yi, during the visit.
Marcos earlier said he wants to increase the scope of Manila's relationship with Beijing, but he also vowed he will not abandon even a square inch of the country's territory.
On the WPS, the president wants a peaceful and stable situation in the West Philippine Sea and will continue to uphold our country's sovereignty and sovereign rights during his meetings with Chinese leaders. And under energy cooperation, the president may raise or continue his discussions with President Xi, which began, by the way, during their initial meeting in Bangkok on oil and gas cooperation. The president will discuss the full range of our bilateral relations, both the positive aspects of it and the sensitive aspects of our relations.